Shropshire Registration Service, and Lizz and Will, may I formally welcome you all to Abel's Harp today, and moreover a very warm welcome to our beautiful county of Shropshire, even in the rain. I understand some of you have been or have come a long way to be with us today. Australia was mentioned, California was mentioned. Very, very warm welcome to you all. Through their vows, Lizz and Will are making a commitment to each other for the rest of their lives. They have invited you all here to witness this commitment, to share their joy and to celebrate their love for each other. They hope that this lovely setting enables everyone to feel at ease and enjoy themselves on this very special day. For Lizz and Will, getting married today confirms the love, the respect and the true friendship that they have for each other. Together they will be stronger to meet whatever life holds for them. A life, we hope, of happiness and fulfilment for them both. This place in which we are met has been duly sanctioned by law for the celebration of marriages. You are all here to witness the joining in matrimony of Lizz Hind to Will Fryer. Any person present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, he or she should declare it now, please. I think we can continue. Now, very important question. Can I ask who presents Lizz to be married to Will today?
I do.
Very proud moment for you, Jeff, to give your daughter to the man she loves. In theory, your job is over.
Thank you.
So for the moment, if you'd like to take your seat. Now you two, for this marriage to be legal, you have to be under the roof. That's it, that's it. First thing I have to do to make sure we're marrying the right people is formally to check your full names. So Will is your full name, William Thomas Fryer.
Yes.
And Lizz is your full name, Elizabeth Anna Hind.
Yes.
Before you are joined in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the ceremony of marriage. and of the implicit nature of the promises you are about to make to each other. According to the law of this country, marriage is the voluntary union of two people to the exclusion of all others. The purpose of marriage is that you may always love, care for, and support each other through the joys and the sorrows of life, and that love may be fulfilled in a relationship of permanent and continuing commitment. I must now ask each of you to declare that you know of no lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. Now, are your witnesses here? Because they need to hear what you're saying. Where are they?
Where's your brother?
Can we have them under this roof? Because they have to sign to say they've heard you. Can we have the two witnesses, please? If you can come underneath, because you're signing to say you've heard. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, go over there. He's not married yet. Okay. So, I need to ask you whether you know of any lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. So will you, Will, please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I will.
Why I will.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Lizz.
To Lizz.
Well done. Lizz, your turn. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Lizz.
Why I, Lizz.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Will.
To Will.
Well done. First hurdle over. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have our first reading. Matthew Taylor, wherever he is. Where's Matthew? Oh. You must have heard that. Would you like to come here, Matthew? Oh, you've got your words, okay. In your own time, then.
No, he's not perfect. No, you aren't either. The two of you will never be perfect. If he can make you laugh at least once, cause you think twice. If he admits to being human and making mistakes, hold on to him and give him the most you can. He isn't going to quote poetry. He's not going to think about you every moment. He'll give you a point. He knows you. Don't hurt him. Don't change him. And don't expect for more than he can give. Don't do lies. Smile when he makes you happy. Yell when he makes you mad. Miss him when he's not there. Love hard when there is love to be had. Perfect guys don't exist, but there's always one guy that is perfect for you.
Thank you very much. We have now reached the part of this wedding ceremony when Lizz and Will enter into their contract of marriage before you, their guests and witnesses. Lizz and Will, you have gathered about you those whom you love most. You have invited them here to receive their encouragement and support in the celebration of your marriage. I now ask you, in the presence of this company, Will you take Lizz to be your lawful wedded wife? Will you comfort her, rejoice with her, and remain true to her for the rest of your life?
I will.
Lizz, will you take Will to be your lawful wedded husband? Will you comfort him, rejoice with him, and remain true to him for the rest of your life?
I will.
And on that very happy note, ladies and gentlemen, we have now reached the most solemn part of this marriage ceremony, when our couple will make the promises that will bind them together as husband and wife. An exchange of rings is the traditional way of showing your love for each other. It is an outward and visible sign of the lifelong promises you are about to make, and to which all the people here today are witnesses. Who has the rings? Where's James? James, please step forward. Thank you very much, James. Right, Will, if you'd like to place that ring on the third finger of Liz's left hand, and holding hands and speaking to her, repeat after me. I call upon these persons here present.
These persons here present.
To witness that I will.
To witness that I will.
Do take thee, Lizz.
Do take thee, Lizz.
To To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And I promise to care for you.
I promise to care for you.
To give you my love and friendship.
To give you my love and friendship.
Support and comfort you.
Support and comfort you.
And to respect and cherish you.
Respect and cherish you.
Throughout our lives together.
Throughout our lives together.
Well done. Will that ring slide down? Oh, it does. Excellent. James, if you'd like to step forward again and offer Liz the groom's ring.
Got it.
Yeah. Thank you, James. Liz, please place that ring on the third finger of Will's left hand. And holding hands and speaking to him, repeat after me. I call upon these persons here present to witness that I, Liz,
do take thee, Will,
to be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of our marriage.
As a symbol of our marriage.
And I promise to care for you.
Sorry.
Everyone's cold, are you?
I promise to care for you. To give you my love and friendship.
To give you my love and friendship.
To support and comfort you.
To support and comfort you.
And to respect and cherish you.
To respect and cherish you.
Throughout our lives together.
Throughout our lives together.
Well done. Oh, that ring slid down nicely. Yeah, perfect. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have our second reading. Kaylee Doyle is going to read The One.
When the one whose hand you're holding is the one whose heart you hold your heart, when the one whose eyes you gaze into gives your hopes and dreams their start.
Both made the declaration that is required by law, and each of you has entered into a solemn and binding contract with the other in the presence of all the guests invited here, the witnesses who will sign the register with you. The next words, I feel sure, are sentiments echoed by everyone here today. May the two of you always be the answer to each other's questions, the gift for each other's needs, and the reason for each other's happiness. May the love that you are feeling now grow stronger and deeper as you travel through life together. By your words and by the law of this country, on behalf of Cheryl and myself, I am delighted to declare that you are now husband and wife together. Best of it is, kiss your bride. Gentlemen, have the signing of the register, which hopefully won't take too long. So if you'd both like to come around here, you're going first, Will. For me to ask you to join with myself and Cheryl in offering congratulations to the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Fryer, as they start their married life together. Round of applause. Wait for your music.
I'm Come on, you. Who does she belong to?
Not mine, mate.
Not you, mate.